This is History for Grade 11, produced by Tigray Education Bureau, transmitted by Dimsuoyane Tigray National and FM radio satellites and social media, and also FM Maqala 104.4.
Hello, students. This is History for Grade 11. Prepared and presented by Yilma Kunnam. Dear students, today we will start on Chapter 7. Chapter 7 says, the Ethiopian region and the Horn of Africa up to 1529. Besides, this chapter contains four major lessons. Lesson 1, the restoration of Solomonic dynasty. Lesson 2, the Muslim states in Ethiopia. Lesson 3, Emetic states in Ethiopia. Lesson 4, the hegemony of Christian Highland Kingdom. Students, let us now deal with the first lesson. 7.1, the restoration of Solomonic dynasty. At the end of this lesson, you will be able to 1. Define the word legend. 2. Identify the benefits of Solomonic dynasty to Ikuna Amlak. 3. Describe the actual reasons for the success of Ikuna Amlak over the Zagwe dynasty. 4. List down the characteristics of Christian Highland Kingdom during the medieval Ethiopia. Students, during the ancient time, King Solomon of Israel and Queen Sheba of Aksum had produced a son called Minilik I. Accordingly, Minilik became the king of ancient Aksum. In doing so, the descendants of Minilik ruled Aksum between 1000 BC to 1150 AD. However, Aksum and the Solomonic dynasty were collapsed because the Ago people defeated the last king of Aksum, known as Dilnaod, in 1150 AD. As a result, the Ago people made political paradigm shift of power from north to south. This implies the political center changed from Aksum to Lalibela. Besides, the Zagwe dynasty ruled between 1150 to 1270 AD. But 120 years later, the Zagwe dynasty failed because it was faced opposition from the Amhara people under the leadership of Ikuna Amlak. Ikuna Amlak regarded himself as the immediate political successor of King Dilnaod, who was the last king of Aksumite state. Students, let's together define the word restoration. Restoration can be defined as regaining something which was lost. For example, it could be power or any other thing. Accordingly, Ikuna Amlak decided to regain the lost power of Solomonic dynasty. To this effect, Ikuna Amlak used the legend of Solomonic dynasty, focused on King Solomon and Queen Sheba, who gave birth to Minilik I. This legend was accepted by the people. As a result, Solomonic legend had provided three theoretical benefits to Ikuna Amlak. Firstly, Ikuna Amlak had got legitimacy and legal acceptance among the Semitic people. Secondly, Solomonic dynasty or Solomonic legend assisted Ikuna Amlak to protect his power from any political contender. Thirdly, this legend helped Ikuna Amlak to denounce Zagwe rulers as illegal power looters. Nevertheless, the practical success of Ikuna Amlak was not dependent on Solomonic legend. Instead, there were three basic reasons for the actual success of Ikuna Amlak over the Zagwe dynasty. 1. Political. Ikuna Amlak had a good relationship with the Christians and Muslim leaders. 2. Economical. Ikuna Amlak controlled and monopolized the profitable trade lines of Red Sea and Gulf of Aden to build his economic capacity. 3. Military reason. Yukunna amlak built up well-organized army against the Zawgye dynasty. Therefore, Yukunna amlak defeated Itvarek, the last king of Zawgye dynasty, and restored Solomonic dynasty in 1270. Hence, Yukunna amlak ruled Christian kingdom up to his death in 1285. However, on the death of Yukunna amlak, political crisis continued among his descendants. As a result, Ambagishan royal prison was established and all the political power contenders were detained. This measure had restored peace and security in the Christian Highland Kingdom. Students, now let's discuss on the characteristics of Christian Highland Kingdom. The medieval Christian Highland Kingdom had 5 main characteristics. 1. Territorial expansion, conflict and constant wars. The main cause of conflict between Christian Highland Kingdom and the Muslim states was the need to control the Zela trade port. 2. Spread of Christianity. Despite Christianity was introduced to Aksumite state, since the 4th century, Christianity process of expansion was very slow as other parts of Ethiopia. For this reason, Christian kings were committed to spread Christianity to Shua, Gojam, and the other regions. 3. Strong church and state relationship was existed. Church and state were supporting each other. Since the medieval period, up to the collapse of Emperor Haile Selassie in 1974. 4. Feudal administration was the fundamental characteristics of medieval Christian Highland Kingdom. Under this feudal system, there are 2 types of rulers. 1. Hereditary rulers. Those were gained power from their ancestors or political fathers. 2. Appointed officials. Those were non-nobles, but they were given power by the top feudal lords. Students, let us see some concepts related to feudal administration. Gult. Gult was the right of feudal lord to collect tributes from the owners of rest and the local people. This process was called gult system. Gult system was used to 1. Simplify the works of administration. 2. Build up local army to attain and sustain peace and security at the local level. Balegult. Balegult was a government official man who was used to act as administrator, judgment giver, lawyer, and other activities among the people. Rist. Rist was a hereditary right to get land ownership from the ancestors. For example, father inherits land to his son. 5. Movable capital city. It was the other characteristics of medieval Ethiopia. This was preferred to achieve 2 goals. 1. Economic goal. It was planned to avoid lack of food and firewood within the medieval army. 2. Political goal. It was targeted to supervise any regional resistance in the Christian Highland Kingdom. As a result, peace and stability were retained until 1636. I will try to summarize the main points of this topic. Please, students, pay your attention and follow me. Yukunna Amlak used the Solomonic legend as theoretical reason to consolidate his legitimate power. However, the claim of Solomonic legend was not a real cause for the success of Yukunna Amlak. Instead, the actual reasons for the success of Yukunna Amlak were political, economical, and military reasons. Therefore, Yukunna Amlak defeated the Zawgye dynasty and restored Solomonic dynasty in 1270. In addition, the Christian Highland Kingdom had 5 main characteristics. 1. Territorial expansion, conflict, and wars. 2. Spread of Christianity. 3. Strong church and state relationship. 4. Feudal administration. 5. Mobile capital city, where, among others to mention. Students, are you ready to answer the questions? Good. Question number one. How can you define the word legend? I will repeat it. How can you define the word legend? The answer is, legend has two definitions. Definition one, legend means a traditional story without any tangible evidence. Therefore, legend has no reality. Second definition, legend means, again, an extremely famous person, either for his goodness or for his badness. For example, Nelson Mandela was a well-known person for his goodness. On the contrary, Adolf Hitler was a famous man for his badness. Question number two. What does restoration mean? What does restoration mean? Answer for question number two. Restoration refers to regaining something which was lost. It could be power. For example, Yukuna Amlak restored the Solomonic dynasty from the Ago people in 1270 Gregorian calendar. Question number three. What were the theoretical benefits of Solomonic legend to Yukuna Amlak? What were the theoretical benefits of Solomonic legend to Yukuna Amlak? Answer for question number three. The theoretical benefits of Solomonic legend to Yukuna Amlak were 1. Yukuna Amlak had got legitimacy or legal acceptance among the Semitic people. 2. Solomonic legend helped Yukuna Amlak to protect his power from any political contender. 3. Solomonic legend assisted Yukuna Amlak to denounce the Aga rulers as illegal power looters. Question number 4. What were the main reasons for the success of Yukuna Amlak over the Zagwe dynasty? What were the main reasons for the success of Yukuna Amlak over the Zagwe dynasty? Answer for question number 4. The main reasons for the success of Yukuna Amlak over the Zagwe dynasty were 1. Political. Yukuna Amlak had a good relationship with the Christians and Muslims. 2. Economical. Yukuna Amlak controlled and monopolized the profitable trade lines of Red Sea and the Gulf of Aden to maximize his economic capacity. 3. Military reason. Yukuna Amlak had built up a well-organized army to defeat the Zagwe dynasty. Question number 5. List down the characteristics of Christian Highland Kingdom in the medieval Ethiopia. List down the characteristics of Christian Highland Kingdom in the medieval Ethiopia. Answer for question number 5. The main characteristics of medieval Christian Highland Kingdom were 1. Territorial expansion, conflicts, and constant wars. 2. Spread of Christianity. 3. Strong church and state relationship. 4. Feudal administration. 5. Mobile capital city. Question number 6. What is the difference between Gult and Balogult? What is the difference between Gult and Balogult? Answer for question number 6. Gult was the right of feudal lord to collect tribute or traditional tax from the owners of rest and the local people. Whereas, Balogult means a government official man who was used to act as administrator, judgment giver, lawyer, and order keeper among the people. Question number 7. Explain the concept of rest. Explain the concept of rest. Answer for question number 7. Rest was a hereditary right to get land ownership from the former ancestors. For example, a feudal father can transfer his land to his son. The practice of rest was continued in Ethiopia after the collapse of Emperor Haile Selassie in 1974 Gregorian calendar. Students, let you open your history book and do the questions on page 154 for the next week. This is all what we have for today. Goodbye, students, until the coming week.